rather than adopting the tone of Jesus in today's gospel, I'd like to adopt the tone of St. Paul in writing to the Thessalonians, perhaps the oldest of the Pauline letters, perhaps the oldest of all New Testament writings. He encouraged his followers, the early disciples of Jesus, to be and to treat one another, and especially those they are evangelizing, as a father treats his children, with exhortation and encouragement. One of the effects of the conference call that I was just on with the Texas bishops was I was relieved of one stop on my travels. I will not have to go to San Antonio on Monday the 25th of September. Following upon the trip to Oklahoma City, I'll be able to come back into the office that day. So my absence will be one day less than you all were anticipating. But I'd like to speak to you, the staff, my representatives, for a moment, as a father would speak to his children. You do so much good work. You're so generous in giving of yourselves in your labors. And I just want to encourage you, misuse of the word, encourage you to exhort and encourage, exactly as Paul said to those he was writing to. In exhortation, not in a rough, demanding way, but in an inviting, encouraging, and catechizing way, and especially to offer encouragement, especially to the people working so hard in the parishes who so much long for and need guidance from our offices, and they need our help. And so I just beg you in the weeks that I will be away from here to try to remember the good parts of your bishop's personality. Not the sinful, weak, crabby parts, but the father-like, encouraging, and teaching aspects, and to carry on the work of the Church of Lubbock in that manner, and know that you will be richly provided for, and that you will be remembered in places like at the tomb of St. Peter, the tomb of St. Robert Bellarmine, the tomb of St. Ignatius of Loyola, all places I intend to visit in the weeks to come.